Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. In this video, we're going to talk about the periodic trend, specifically the horizontal periodic trend that we encounter when we talk about effective nuclear charge and electronegativity. So on the screen, we have just a small snippet of a periodic table, and we have the first and second rows, and I want to highlight the second row. So right in the middle, it's a little bit hidden of the screen, are some electronegativity values, and lowercase e capital N, so we can see at the bottom right of the screen, that is sort of a shorthand for electronegativity. And so the electronegativity of carbon is 2.5, nitrogen is 3.0, oxygen is 3.4, and fluorine is 4.0. So why do we see this change in electronegativity as we move horizontally across the periodic table? And we've selected period 2 because these are the elements that we commonly encounter in organic chemistry. But this trend would hold up for period 3, 4, 5, what have you. Well, what changes as we go across the periodic table, as we know, is the effect of nuclear charge. So toward the top of the screen, the effect of nuclear charge for these elements, carbon is in group 4, that's Roman numeral 4, so its effective nuclear charge is 4. Nitrogen is 5, oxygen is 6, and fluorine is 7. And incidentally, these values are the same as the valence electrons. So that's also the valence electron count. So, as you build up this effective nuclear charge in these elements, as we go across the periodic table from carbon to fluorine, remember, effective nuclear charge is in a sense it's an attraction between the nucleus, the protons in the nucleus, and the valence electrons. So no surprise, electronegativity also increases as you move across the periodic table. And electronegativity itself is also a measure of affinity for electrons. So as the attractive force increases, electronegativity increases. And this is a general trend on the left, that as effective nuclear charge increases, our electronegativity is going to increase. Now, one other thing I want to throw in, as you increase this attraction, you get a slight decrease in the size of the atom. So up here, it's van der Waals radius, and this, we're running out of space, but this is in units of angstroms, and angstroms are 10 to the minus 10th meters. It's a really common unit that you encounter for van der Waals radius. So what happens to the van der Waals radii of these elements? Well, carbon is about 1.7 angstroms. Nitrogen is about 1.55, a little smaller, just a bit smaller still, is oxygen at 1.52, and fluorine is 1.47. So you see this slight yet noticeable contraction of these elements as you move across the periodic table. People attribute that to an effect of effective nuclear charge, as well as increasing electronegativity. So this is a really common periodic trend that you will encounter, that as effective nuclear charge increases, electronegativity increases as well, and you get a slight contraction in size in the elements as you move strictly horizontally across the periodic table.